I am Professor Biju Balakrishnan, working with SIS Graduate School of Technology, Navi Mumbai. The topic I am going to explain here is cyclic code. Cyclic code is a type of block code. Any block code is said to be a cyclic code if it satisfies linearity and cyclic properties. First, I'll explain what is the meaning of a linearity property. XOR of any two valid code words. If the result is a valid code word, then the code satisfies linearity property. And next, cyclic property. Cyclic rotation of any valid code should be a valid code. So if both properties are going to be satisfied, we can say that block code is a cyclic code. All linear block codes are not cyclic code, but all cyclic codes are linear block code. The reason is, if the block code satisfying linearity property, it is a linear block code. But for cyclic code, linearity property and cyclic property should be satisfied. First, I'll explain how the cyclic code can be generated. Then I'll explain from the received code word how the original signal can be or original code word can be determined. There are two different types of cyclic code. One is non-systematic cyclic code and second one is a systematic cyclic code. And when you are saying it's a systematic cyclic code, total number of bits we are going to generate will be n and the number of message bits are k. That is why the block code is known as n, k block code. Meaning of that is, from k message bits, n bits code is going to be generated. Out of n bits, k bits are message bits and n minus k bits are parity bits. From this n bits, if you are able to say like this, the first k bits are data bits and the last n minus k bits are parity bits, the code is always systematic. The first doesn't indicate that, okay, the left side or right side. Maybe we can say like this, the leftmost k bits are data bits, rightmost n minus k bits are parity bits, the code is systematic. Or rightmost k bits are data bits, leftmost n minus k bits are parity bit, the code is systematic. If you are not able to say where is data bit and where is parity bit, then the code is non-systematic code. First, I'll explain how non-systematic cyclic code can be generated. For that, the procedure is C of x is equal to d of x into g of x. What is d of x? That is a data polynomial. So whatever be the given data, that should be converted into polynomial format. And the generator polynomial that is needed for generating the cyclic code. These two are going to be multiplied. The result is known as code polynomial. From the code polynomial, we are able to write the code bits. C of x is code polynomial with a maximum degree n minus 1 because the total number of bits are n. So when you are writing, when you are converting that one into polynomial format, the maximum degree is n minus 1 because we are writing x raised to 0 plus x raised to 1 plus x raised to 2, etc. That is why the degree of the polynomial is always number of bits minus 1. D of x is a data polynomial, number of bits are k, so the degree of the polynomial will be k minus 1. Generator polynomial. So here the procedure is like this. C of x is d of x into g of x. And our requirement is degree of c of x should be n minus 1. And the degree of d of x is k minus 1. So we are able to say if the degree of g of x is n minus k, then after multiplication, we are able to get the required degree, that is n minus 1. So g of x is a generator polynomial with the degree n minus k. Next, systematic cyclic code generation. For a systematic cyclic code generation, C of x is equal to, that is the code polynomial is equal to, x raised to n minus k into d of x XOR P of x, where P of x is a remainder of x raised to n minus k into d of x upon g of x. That is, what is the first step is, d of x, that is data polynomial should be determined. That d of x should be multiplied with x raised to n minus k, where n minus k is a number of parity bits. And what will be the product? That product divided by generator polynomial will get a remainder. And based on that remainder, the parity bits can be determined. The degree of remainder is always 1 less than degree of remainder, 1 less than degree of denominator. and the denominator degree, that is n minus k, so the degree of remainder will be n minus k minus 1. If the degree is n minus k minus 1, it is equivalent to n minus k bits. So after doing the division, n minus k parity bits can be obtained. So due to this x raised to n minus k into d of x multiplication, data bits will be shifted to left by n minus k position. So out of n bits, the first k bits always, first k bits will be data bits, and the last n minus k bits will be the parity bits. The parity bits are going to be obtained after doing the division. That is why this method is also known as a division method. Using the division, the parity bits are going to be generated. Here I am showing examples of non-systematic cyclic code generation and systematic cyclic code generation. First, non-systematic cyclic code generation. First example, I am taking a 7,4 code. 7,4 code is going to be generated. That means the meaning of that is from 4 data bits, we are going to generate 3 parity bits. And then finally 4 plus 3, 7 bits code is going to be generated. And example here, I am taking 3 data bits. 0011, 1011, and 1111, and the selected generator polynomial is x cube plus x square plus 1. So that means we are going to generate code word using the generator polynomial x cube plus x square plus 1. First example, data bit is 0011, data bit is 0011. This data will be converted into polynomial, that is the equivalent polynomial is d of x is equal to x plus 1. 0011 is converted into polynomial format, and this 1 is multiplied by x raised to 0, this 1 is multiplied by x raised to 1, this is multiplied by x square, and the MSB bit is multiplied by x cube. So 0 into x cube plus 0 into x square plus 1 into x plus 1 into x raised to 0. That is why d of x is x plus 1. C of x is equal to d of x into g of x. D of x, x plus 1, g of x is x cube plus x square plus 1. After multiplication, x raised to 4 plus x cube plus x cube plus x square plus 1. All this addition is XOR addition. Due to that reason, x cube plus x cube is equal to 0. So final answer is x raised to 4 plus x square plus x plus 1. And this should be converted into 7 bits code. For converting into 7 bits code, the degree of the polynomial should be 6. And here we can see there is no x raised to 6. That is why against x raised to 6, 0. No x raised to 5. That is why 0. X raised to 4 existing, so it's 1. No x cube, again 0. X square is there. X is also there. And 1 is there. So the 7 bits code we generated 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. This is the non-systematic 7,4 cyclic code for the data 0011 using the generator polynomial x cube plus x square plus 1. Second example is d is equal to 1011. D is equal to 1011. Again, that is converted into polynomial format, that is x cube plus x plus 1. C of x is equal to data polynomial into generator polynomial. Data polynomial is x cube plus x plus 1. Generator polynomial x cube plus x square plus 1. After multiplication, x raised to 6 plus x raised to 5 plus x cube plus x raised to 4 plus x cube plus x cube plus x square plus 1. Again, due to XOR addition, x cube plus x cube cancelled. Final answer is x raised to 6 plus x raised to 5 plus x raised to 4 plus x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. This is converted into code word x raised to 6, x raised to 5, x raised to 4, x cube, x square, x and 1. So this example shows that the data bit and code word, okay, we are not able to find out the location of data bits. The data consists of 1, 0, and you can see there is no 0 in the code word. That is the meaning of a non-systematic code. We are generating a code word equivalent to a data bits 1011. We cannot say where is data bit and where is parity bit in a code word. That is the meaning of a non-systematic code. In a non-systematic code, we are not able to say which bits are data bits and which bits are parity bits. If you are able to say in advance, then it is systematic. Surely, due to this reason, it is difficult to decode at the receiving side. So decoding complexity will be more if the code is non-systematic. Surely, the complexity can be reduced if the code is systematic. Second, systematic cyclic code generation. Again, example is 7,4 code, 7,4 code, and the same data words are used: 0011, 1011, and 1111. G of x is x cube plus x square plus 1. The first step is d should be converted into data polynomial. So data polynomial is written x plus 1. This x plus 1 is multiplied by x raised to n minus k. So x cube into x plus 1, that is x raised to 4 plus x cube. This product will be the first part of the final answer. Next, we have to do the division. For the doing division, P of x is equal to remainder of x raised to 4 plus x cube divided by x cube plus x square plus 1. X cube plus x square plus 1 is a generator polynomial. So I am showing the division here: x raised to 4 plus x cube divided by x cube plus x square plus 1. Every time MSP term is going to be cancelled. So x into x cube, x raised to 4, x into x square, x cube, x into 1x. Now, instead of doing subtraction between this and this, do the addition, because in a XOR operation, subtraction is equivalent to addition. So x raised to 4 plus x raised to 4, 0, x cube plus x cube, 0, and 0 plus x is equal to x. So the remainder is equal to x. This remainder we should take here. So the remainder is equal to x, and the previous product we are getting x raised to 4 plus x cube. So the final answer is x raised to 4 plus x cube plus x, where x is the remainder we are getting after doing the division, and x raised to 4 plus x cube we are getting after doing the multiplication. This is that x raised to 4 plus x cube. So x raised to 4 plus x cube plus x. Again, this should be written in terms of ones and zeros. And for a 7,4 cyclic code, the degree of code polynomial is n minus 1, that is 7 minus 1 is equal to 6. So here we can see there is no x raised to 6, that is by 0. There is no x raised to 5, again 0. There is x raised to 4, that is by 1. There is x cube, again 1. No x square, 0. X is there, so it's 1. And there is no 1, so it is 0. So 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. Out of the 7 bits, you can see the leftmost 4 bits are data bits and the rightmost 3 bits are parity bits. So that is why it is a systematic cyclic code. Systematic cyclic code means the data bits and parity bits are in a fixed position. And here always it is like this: leftmost 4 bits are data bits, rightmost 3 bits are parity bits. So it is a systematic code. Second example, d is equal to 1011. Again, that is converted into polynomial, that is x cube plus x plus 1, and that polynomial is multiplied with x raised to n minus k, that is x raised to n minus k is x cube into data polynomial x cube plus x plus 1, and the product is x raised to 6 plus x raised to 4 plus x cube. That's a product. That product will be the first part of code polynomial. Now we want to find out the second part of that code polynomial, that is a remainder. For that, we are doing the division here. That is x raised to 6 plus x raised to 4 plus x cube divided by generator polynomial x cube plus x square plus 1. And after doing the division, the remainder is x square. So when you are doing the division should be stopped when the remainder degree is less than denominator degree. Denominator degree is equal to 3, so the maximum degree of remainder should be 2. So here we got x square, so that will be the remainder. And this remainder should be taken as a last part of the code polynomial. And the first part is the product initially we got. So x raised to 6 plus x raised to 4 plus x cube plus the remainder. Remainder is x square. This is a code polynomial. And each code polynomial should be written in terms of ones and zeros. That will be the code word for the given data bits. So x raised to 6, it is there. X raised to 5, not existing, so 0. X raised to 4, x cube, x square, no x, and no 1. So what the final answer we are getting is 1011100. Out of the 7 bits, first 4 bits are data bits, These 4 bits are data bits, and the last 3 bits are parity bits. 1011 is data bits and 100 is the parity bit. Third example, d is equal to 111, that is converted into polynomial, that is x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. This polynomial is multiplied by x cube, so the product is x raised to 6 plus x raised to 5 plus x raised to 4 plus x cube. That will be the first part of quad polynomial. First part of the quad polynomial. Now we want to find out the remainder. For calculating the remainder, division is needed. So the division I am doing here, x raised to 6 plus x raised to 5 plus x raised to 4 plus x cube divided by x cube plus x square plus 1. And after doing the division, the remainder is x square plus x plus 1. Again, the division should be stopped when the remainder degree is less than 3. So now the less than 3, so the remainder is x square plus x plus 1. This x square plus x plus 1 should be added with that previous product. So final quad polynomial is x raised to 6 plus x raised to 5 plus x raised to 4 plus x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. And that is converted into ones and zeros. So the final answer is 111111. Out of the 7 ones, leftmost 4 ones are data bits, rightmost 3 ones are parity bits. Now I'll explain how cyclic code is going to process at the receiving side. Surely at the receiving side, the process are error detection, correction and decoding. So when the data is going to be transmitted through any communication channel, there is a probability of error. Due to that error, the transmitted code and received code may not be same. We'll say the transmitted code is C and the received code is R, and C and R may not be same. So first we should verify that error existing in the received code or not. That is known as error detection. If error existing, then the next step is that error should be corrected. And after correcting error, we are able to get the original code word, that is R will be converted to C. After doing the correction, removing parity bits, so we'll get the original data, that is known as decoding. So error detection, error correction and decoding. Basically there are 3 steps at the receiving side when we are processing the error control code at the receiving side. So here first step is cyclic code error detection and correction, that is error detection. For that one, what is the first step is calculate syndrome polynomial. That is based on the syndrome, the receiver is able to determine error existing or not existing. The syndrome polynomial S of x is equal to remainder of R of x upon G of x. R of x is the received polynomial, G of x is the received polynomial. And a transmitted polynomial is known as C of x. C of x and R of x may not be same. Due to error, C of x may not be equal to R of x. So C of x is a transmitted polynomial, R of x is a received polynomial, and syndrome is going to be calculated from R of x and G of x. So S of x is the remainder of R of x upon G of x, where R of x is equal to received code polynomial, G of x is a generator polynomial, and now the algorithm is saying like this, if S of x is equal to 0, there is no error. That is, syndrome is equal to 0, that indicates that the received code is a valid code. There is no error. If S of x is not equal to 0, that is an indication error existing in the received code word. So it's a very easy procedure to determine error existing or not existing. After calculating syndrome polynomial, we are able to say error existing or not existing. So I'll repeat, if syndrome polynomial is equal to 0, there is no error. If there is no error, directly decoding can be done. Just remove the parity bits and the original data can be obtained at the receiving side. But if S of x is not equal to 0, that's an indication error existing in the received code word, then error correction is needed. After error correction only, that decoding can be done. So next I'll explain how error can be corrected. For that one, we need a syndrome table. Syndrome table is also known as decoding table. The list of error patterns the decoder can correct and the corresponding syndromes is called a decoding table. That means the decoding table consists of list of error patterns the receiver is able to correct and the corresponding syndromes. And once we are going for a 7, 4 cyclic code and its error correction capability is equal to 1 bit error. meaning that one is anywhere one bit error occurring, it can be detected and corrected. So in a 7 bits code word, the position of error can occur from leftmost bit to the rightmost bit. So there are seven different positions. That is why we are able to say there are 7 error patterns in 7,4 cyclic code, and these 7 error patterns the receiver is able to detect and correct. So this 7 error patterns will write in a table. That's a list of error patterns receiver is able to correct, and against each error pattern the corresponding syndrome is going to be determined. Against each error pattern, the corresponding syndrome can be calculated using the following equation. So that equation is S of x is equal to remainder of E of x by G of x, where E of x is the error polynomial and G of x is the generator polynomial previously we used. That error polynomial should be written based on the error correction capability of the cyclic code. If it is 7,4 cyclic code, its correction capability is only 1 bit error. So only one error can be detected and corrected at the receiving cell. So that error pattern consists of 1, 1 and all remaining bits are zeros. That 1 is an indication that particular bit is error bit. If the leftmost bit I am showing 1, so leftmost bit is error bit and the remaining bits are not error bits. It's written here where S of x is a syndrome polynomial and E of x is error polynomial. Length of syndrome is n minus k and the length of error pattern is n. Length of error pattern and the length of code are same. I'm showing an example how syndrome table can be obtained. 7,4 can correct only 1 bit error. So the possible error patterns, here I'm showing the possible error patterns. These are the possible error pattern the receiver is able to correct, not the complete list of error pattern. Total number of error patterns are 2^7, that is 128. Out of this 128, only this 8 error pattern receiver is able to correct. The first error pattern, that is 70, that is an indication there is no error. That means transmitted code and received codes are same. Second error pattern, that is 1, then 6 zeros, this is an indication leftmost bit is error bit. Next error pattern is an indication second bit is error bit. And the last error pattern indicates that last bit is error bit. If I am saying there is only 1 bit error, there are only 7 different positions. Leftmost bit or second bit, third bit, etc. 7th bit. And these are the 7 error patterns. And the first error pattern shows that there is no error. Against each error pattern, we should be able to find out the corresponding syndrome. The first error pattern is E is equal to, that is 7 consecutive zeros. The corresponding polynomial is equal to 0. So S of x is equal to remainder of E of x by G of x. That is remainder of 0 by G of x, that is by 0. So S of x is equal to 0, but the length of S is equal to n minus k, that is 7 minus 4 is equal to 3. That is why S is written 0, 0, 0. Length of syndrome bits and length of parity bits are same. So S is equal to 0, 0, 0. Second error pattern, 1 followed by 6 zeros. Corresponding polynomial is equal to x^6. Syndrome polynomial is remainder of x^6 divided by x³ plus x² plus 1. Remainder of x^6 divided by x³ plus x² plus 1. After doing the division, the remainder is x² plus x. That is again converted into 1s and 0, that is 1, 1, 0. This indicates that against error pattern 1 followed by 6 zeros, the corresponding syndrome is 1, 1, 0. Similarly, for each error pattern, the syndrome polynomial is going to be calculated. For the second error pattern, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, the corresponding polynomial is x^5. And after doing the division, the remainder is x plus 1. That x plus 1 is converted in terms of 1 and 0, that is 0, 1, 1. Next error polynomial, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. Equivalent polynomial is x^4. After doing the division, remainder is x² plus x plus 1, and the corresponding syndrome bits are 1, 1, 1. For the next error polynomial, x³, after doing the division with the generator polynomial, the remainder is x² plus 1, and the corresponding bits, that is syndrome bits, are 1, 1, 1. The last three error patterns are showing here. These are the last three error patterns. And the corresponding polynomials are x², x and 1. So x² divided by x³ plus That is the generator polynomial x cube plus x square plus 1, remainder is x square and the corresponding bits are 1, 0, 0. Next error polynomial is x, x upon x cube plus x square plus 1, remainder is x and the corresponding bits are 0, 1, 0. And the last error polynomial is 1, 1 divided by x cube plus x square plus 1, remainder is also 1. And when it is written in terms of zeros and 1, it is 0, 0, 1. So in this table, I am showing the list of error pattern and the corresponding syndromes. Total number of error patterns are 8. Out of these 8, the first 7 error patterns consists of 1, 1, meaning that one is there is 1 bit error. And the last error pattern, this last error pattern, this is an indication there is no error. So there is 1 error or there is no error. There is a possibility 2 or more errors can occur, but our system is not capable of correcting 2 or more bit errors. So our system, that is 7,4 cyclic code, is capable of correcting only up to 1 bit error. That is why we are writing only no error and 1 error combination. So 7 plus 1 is the total 8 error patterns are written here. Otherwise total number of error patterns are 128. Out of these 128, only 8 error patterns our system is able to detect and correct at the receiving set. Corresponding syndromes are written here. So this is known as syndrome table. Syndrome table for 7,4 cyclic code with a generator polynomial x cube plus x square plus 1. If you are changing the generator polynomial, syndrome table is going to change. Next, what are the steps needed for a given received code? Okay. That is calculate syndrome for a received code. So if the received code is given, this is the received code is given 1000010. For this received code, what's the first step is we should verify error existing or not. The verification can be done after calculating syndrome. And the generated polynomial is x cube plus x square plus 1. The received polynomial is converted into polynomial format, that is x raised to 6 plus x. S of x is a remainder of x raised to 6 plus x divided by x cube plus x square plus 1. X cube plus x square plus 1 is the generator polynomial and the remainder is x square. Remainder is not equal to 0 is an indication error existing in the received code, and x square indicates that syndrome is equal to 100. So syndrome is not equal to 0, it's written here, syndrome is not equal to 0, and that is an indication the received code is not a valid code, that is error existing in the received code. Once error existing, next we should do the correction, that is error correction. So the fourth step is error correction, and the error is going to be corrected with the help of decoding table or that syndrome table. The decoding table shows that for syndrome 100, the corresponding error pattern is 00001000. This I have selected from the decoding table because the decoding table consists of list of error pattern and corresponding syndrome. Here we calculated syndrome for a given received code. Against that syndrome, there is an equivalent error pattern. That error pattern is selected here. So for selection of this, we should go back to our decoding table. From the decoding table, the corresponding error pattern is selected. And once as error pattern is selected, then the correction procedure is like this. C is equal to R plus E. That is, corrected code is received code plus error pattern we have selected from decoding table. Received code is 1000010, and the corresponding error pattern we selected from decoding table is 00001000. After XORing, this is the corrected code 1000110. This is the corrected code. That code consists of 7 bits, but out of 7 bits, only 4 bits are data bits, 3 bits are parity bits. And selecting the data bits, that's the last step, that's called decoding. In C, C is equal to 1000110. This is a corrected code. And initially we got that answer, leftmost 4 bits are data bits and rightmost 3 bits are parity bits. So out of the 7 bits, leftmost 4 bits are 1000. This 100 is the data bits, and last 3 bit, that is 110, we can say it's a parity bit. So when you are doing decoding, parity should be removed, so the final data bits are 1000. So that means for error detection and correction, the steps involved are: first, calculate syndrome. From the syndrome, we'll get an idea error existing or not existing. If error existing, then against that syndrome, the error pattern should be selected from the decoding table. That means the decoding table should be made in advance. Against each syndrome, there is an equivalent error pattern, so that error pattern should be selected. Next step is the selected error pattern should XOR with the received code. Whatever be the answer we are getting will be the corrected code. And from the corrected code, remove parity bits, select only the final data bits. That will be the final output of decoder. So here I just complete the encoding and decoding procedure for a cyclic code. Good day.